हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर फिट एंड फाइन। दिस इज फॉर क्लास फोर्थ, सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स, चैप्टर नंबर 5, डिवीजन, समरी लेक्चर। इन दिस लेक्चर आई शैल समराइज दिस चैप्टर नंबर 5, डिवीजन। नाउ इंट्रोडक्शन टू डिवीजन। व्हाट इज डिवीजन? डिवीजन इज ए मेथड ऑफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिंग ए ग्रुप ऑफ थिंग्स इनटू इक्वल parts. Division is a method of distributing a group of things into equal parts. Or division is an operation that is just the opposite of multiplication. Or division is an operation that is just the opposite of multiplication. Now question number 1. Divide a part. 155 divided 5 equal to dash. See, 155 is dividend and 5 is divisor. Write down answer. Make a sign like this. Write 5 here and write 155 here. See, 5 is one digit divisor. So we will take only first digit of the dividend, that is 1. But 1 is less than 5. So we will take one more digit, that is 5. Number formed is 15. Now multiply this 5 by that number so that it is equal to 15 or less than 15. It should not be greater than 15. See, 5 multiply 3 equal to 15. Now we will do subtraction. 5 minus 5, 0. 1 minus 1, 0. Now we will take next number, that is 5. Now 5 ones are 5. Now we will do subtraction. 5 minus 5, 0. Quotient equal to 31. Remainder equal to 0. Thus 155 divided 5 equal to 31. Clear? Now B part. 404 divided 4 equal to dash. 404 is dividend and 4 is divisor. Write down answer. Make a sign like this. Write 4 here and write 404 here. Now see, 4 is one digit divisor. So we will take only first digit of the dividend, that is 4. See, 4 multiply 1 equal to 4. Now we will do subtraction. 4 minus 4, 0. And then we will take next number, that is 0. Okay, but 0 is less than 4. So we will take one more digit, that is 4. And then we will put 1 0 in the quotient. Clear? Now again multiply 4 by 1. 4 multiply 1 equal to 4. Now we will do subtraction. 4 minus 4, 0. Quotient equal to 101. Remainder equal to 0. Write down. Thus 404 divided 4 equal to 101. Clear? Now properties of division. Number 1. Dividing by 1. If a number is divided by 1, the quotient is the number itself. If a number is divided by 1, the quotient is the number itself. अगर हम कोई भी नंबर को 1 के साथ डिवाइड करेंगे तो हमारा quotient वही सेम नंबर आएगा. For example, a part 47 divide 1 equal 47. See, if we divide 47 by 1, the quotient is the number itself, that is 47. B part 621 divide 1 equal 621. Number 2, dividing by the number itself. If a number other than 0 is divided by itself, the quotient is 1. If a number other than 0 is divided by itself, the quotient is 1. For example, a part 6425 divide 6425. Here we are dividing 6425 by same number, that is 6425. Quotient is 1. B part 9213 divide 9213 equal 1. Now number 3, dividing 0 by any number. If 0 is divided by a number other than 0, the quotient is 0. If 0 is divided by a number other than 0, the quotient is 0. For example, a part 0 divide 645 equal 0. B part 0 divide 346 equal 0. Now number 4, dividing a number by 0. A number cannot be divided by 0. Division by 0 is meaningless. Here we can't divide a number by 0. Division by 0 is meaningless. Now number 5, multiplication and division facts. Every division sum has a division fact and a multiplication fact to verify it. Every division sum has a division fact and a multiplication fact to verify it. I will explain you an example. See, a part in 18 divide 3 equal 6. 18 is dividend and 3 is divisor and 6 is quotient. Division fact equal 18 divide 6. See, 18 is dividend and quotient is 6. We will divide dividend by quotient. See, 18 divide 6 equal 3. And multiplication fact equal 3 multiply 6. We will multiply divisor and quotient. 3 multiply 6 equal 18. Thus, this division sum has a division fact and multiplication fact to verify it. We have verified. Now, some important points to remember. Number 1, there is a formula to check division sum. Dividend equal divisor multiply quotient plus remainder. Dividend equal divisor multiply quotient plus remainder. Number 2, in division sums, when no remainder is left or the remainder is 0, the dividend is exactly divisible. In division sums, when no remainder is left or the remainder is 0, the dividend is exactly divisible. Number 3, the remainder is always less than the divisor. The remainder is always less than the divisor. Now, division by one digit divisor. For example, question number 1, divide 477 by 4. Here we will divide 477 by 4. Answer, make lines like this, write 477 here because 477 is dividend and 4 is divisor, so write on left side. See, now multiply this 4 by that number so that it is equal to 4 or less than 4. It should not be greater than 4. See, 4 multiply 1 equal 4. Now we will do subtraction. 4 minus 4, 0. And then we will take next number, that is 7. Write here 7. Now again multiply this 4 by that number so that it is equal to 7 or less than 7. It should not be greater than 7. See, 4 multiply 1 equal 4 and 4 multiply 2 equal 8. 8 is greater than 7, so we will not multiply by 2. See, 4 multiply 1 equal 4. Write 4 here. See, now we will do subtraction. 7 minus 4, 3. And then we will take next number, that is 7. Write here 7. Number becomes 37. Now, multiply this 4 by that number so that it is equal to 37 or less than 37. It should not be greater than 37. See, 4 multiply 9 equal 36. Write here 36. Now we will do subtraction. See, 7 minus 6, 1 and 3 minus 3, 0. Hence, quotient is 119 and remainder equal 1. And now we will check our answer. Now, write down dividend equal to 477, divisor equal to 4. Quotient equal to 119 and remainder equal to 1. Write down dividend equal to divisor multiply quotient plus remainder. 477 equal to 4 multiply 119 plus 1. First multiply 119 by 4. See, 119 multiply 4. 4 nines are 36. Write 6 here and 3 carry. 4 ones are 4 plus 3 7. Write 7 here. 4 ones are 4. Write 4 here. 119 multiply 4 equal to 476. Write down equal to 476 plus 1. That is equal to 477. See, left hand side and right hand side both are equal.
hence answer is verified. Clear?
Now, division by two-digit divisor. For example, question number 1. Divide 795 by 13. Here we will divide 795 by 13. Answer, make lines like this. Write 795 here and 13 here. 795 is dividend and 13 is divisor. So, two-digit divisor. So, we will take first two-digit in dividend. That is 7 and 9. Number becomes 79. Now multiply this 13 by that number so that it is equal to 79 or less than 79. It should not be greater than 79. See, 13 multiply 6 equal 78. Now we will do subtraction. 9 minus 8, 1 and 7 minus 7, 0. Now we will take next number, that is 5. Write here 5, number becomes 15. Now multiply again this 13 by that number so that it is equal to 15 or less than 15. It should not be greater than 15. 13 multiply 1 equal 13. Now we will do subtraction. 5 minus 3, 2 and 1 minus 1, 0. Hence, quotient equal 61 and remainder equal 2. And now we will check our answer.
Now, write down dividend equal to 795, divisor equal to 13, quotient equal to 61 and remainder equal to 2. Write down dividend equal to divisor multiply quotient plus remainder. 795 equal to 13 multiply 61 plus 2. First multiply 13 by 61. See, 13 multiply 61. 1 3 is a 3, 1 1 is a 1. Now put 1 cross here, now multiply 13 by 6. 6 3 is a 18, write 8 here and 1 carry. 6 1 is a 6 plus 1, 7, write 7 here. Now we will do addition. Write 3 here, 1 plus 8, 9, write 9 here and write 7 as it is. 13 multiply 61 equal to 793. Write down equal to 793 plus 2 and that is equal to 795. See, left hand side and right hand side both are equal. Hence, answer is verified. Clear? Now, division by 10, 100 and 1000. See, first, if the divisor is 10, the last digit of the dividend is the remainder and the number formed by the remaining digits is the quotient. For example, A part, 934 divided 10. Quotient equal to dash and remainder equal to dash. See, divisor is 10. So, the last digit of the dividend, that is 4, will be remainder and the number formed by the remaining digits, that is 9 and 3. Number formed is 93. That will be quotient. Write down answer. 934 divided 10. Quotient equal to 93 and remainder equal to 4. Clear? Now, second, if the divisor is 100, the number formed by the last two digits of the dividend is the remainder and the number formed by the remaining digits is the quotient. For example, A part 674 divided 100, quotient equal to dash and remainder equal to dash. See, divisor is 100. Then the number formed by the last two digits of the dividend, that is 7 and 4, number formed is 74. That will be remainder and the number formed by the remaining digit, that is 6, that will be quotient. Write down answer. 674 divided 100. Quotient equal to 6 and remainder equal to 74. Clear? Now, third, if the divisor is 1000, the number formed by the last three digits of the dividend is the remainder and the number formed by the remaining digits is the quotient. For example, A part 8460 divided 1000. Quotient equal to dash and remainder equal to dash. See, divisor is 1000. Then the number formed by the last three digits of the dividend, that is 4, 6 and 0. Number formed is 460. That will be remainder. And the number formed by the remaining digit, that is 8, that will be quotient. Write down answer. 8460 divided 1000. Quotient equal to 8 and remainder equal to 460. Clear? Now, word problems on division. Question number 1. A company paid ₹6,996 as airfare for 3 tickets to travel from New Delhi to Hyderabad. What was the fare of 1 ticket? Answer. Amount paid for 3 tickets equal to ₹6,996. Amount paid for 1 ticket equal to ₹6,996 divided 3. We will divide 6,996 by 3. Make a sign like this. Write 3 here and write 6,996 here. Okay. Now see, 3 is one digit divisor. So we will take only first digit of the dividend, that is 6. multiply 3 multiply 2 equal to 6. Now we will do subtraction. 6 minus 6, 0. And then we will take next number, that is 9. Now multiply 3 multiply 3 equal to 9. Now we will do subtraction. 9 minus 9, 0. And then we will take next number, that is 9. Now again multiply 3 by 3. 3 multiply 3 equal to 9. Now we will do subtraction. 9 minus 9, 0. And then we will take next number, that is 6. Now multiply 3 by 2. 3 multiply 2 equal to 6. Now we will do subtraction. 6 minus 6, 0. Okay. Write down. Therefore, the airfare for one ticket to travel from New Delhi to Hyderabad equal to rupees 2,332. Therefore, the airfare for one ticket to travel from New Delhi to Hyderabad equal to rupees 2,332. Clear? Now, note down, do the given assignment number 1 of chapter number 5, division. And assignment number 1 will be uploaded on EdQuark website and on WhatsApp groups. Clear? Now, I will discuss homework solutions of lecture number 7 of chapter number 5, division. Now, solve the following questions. Worksheet given on page number 55. Question number 3. Find the quotient and remainder. D part. 78,096 divided 1,000. Quotient equal to dash, remainder equal to dash. See, divisor is 1,000. So, the number formed by the last three digits of the dividend, that is 0, 9 and 6. Number formed is 96. That will be remainder. And the number formed by the remaining digits, that is 7 and 8. That seven number formed is 78. That will be quotient. Write down. Answer. 78,096 divided 1,000. Quotient equal to 78. Remainder equal to 96. Clear? Now, E part. 736 divided 10. Quotient equal to dash. Remainder equal to dash. See, divisor is 10. So, the number formed by the last digit of the dividend, that is 6. That will be remainder. And the number formed by the remaining digits, that is 7 and 3. That number formed is 73. That will be quotient. Write down answer. 736 divided 10, quotient equal to 73, remainder equal to 6. Clear? Now, F part. 450 divided 50, quotient equal to dash, remainder equal to dash. See, 10 is given in dividend and 10 is given in dividend. That will be, 10 is given in dividend and 10 is given in divisor. So, this 0 and this 0 will be cancelled. Now, divide 45 by 5. 45 divided 5 equal to 9. So, quotient will be 9 and remainder will be 0. So, write down answer. 450 divided 50, quotient equal to 9, remainder equal to 0. Clear? Now, question number 4. Divide and check your answer. B part. 707,070 divided 62. Write down answer. Make a sign like this. Write 62 here and write 707,070 here. Now, see, 62 is 2-digit divisor. So, we will take only first two digits of the dividend, that is 70. Okay. Now, multiply the 62 by that number so that it is equal to 70 or less than 70. That should not be greater than 70. 62 multiply 1 equal to 62. Now, we will do subtraction. 0 minus 2, it is not possible. So, we will take borrow from this 7. So, this 7 will become 6 and this 0 will become 10. 10 minus 2, 8. 6 minus 6, 0. And then we will take next number, that is 7. Number formed is 87. Now, again multiply 62 by 1. 62 multiply 1 equal to 62. Now, we will do subtraction. 7 minus 2, 5. 8 minus 6, 2. And then we will take next number, that is 0. Number formed is 250. Now, multiply the 60 by that number so that it is equal to 250 or less than 250. That should not be greater than 250. See, 62 multiply 4. 4 2 is 8. Write 8 here. 4 6 is 24. Write 24 here. 62 multiply 4 equal to 248. So, multiply the 62 by 4. 62 multiply 4 equal to 258. And then we will do subtraction. 0 minus 8. It is not possible. So, we will take borrow from this 5. So, this 5 will become 4 and this 0 will become 10. 10 minus 8, 2. 4 minus 4, 0. 2 minus 2, 0. And then we will take next number, that is 7. Now, number formed is 27. But 27 is less than 62. Okay. So, we will take one more digit, that is 0. Okay, but and then we will write 10 in quotient. Now the number formed is 270. Now again multiply the 62 by 4. 62 multiply 4 equal to 248. Now we will do subtraction. 0 minus 8, it is not possible. So take borrow from this 7. So this 7 will become 6 and this 0 will become 10. 10 minus 8, 2. 6 minus 4, 2. Quotient equal to 11,404 and remainder equal to 22. Write down quotient equal to 11,404, remainder equal to 22. Now write down dividend equal to 7,07,070, divisor equal to 62, quotient equal to 11,404 and remainder equal to 22. Write down dividend equal to divisor multiply quotient plus remainder. 7,07,070 equal to 62 multiply 11,404 plus 22. First multiply 11,404 by 62. See, 11,404 multiply 62. 2 fours are 8, write 8 here. 2 zeros are 0, write 0 here. 2 fours are 8, write 8 here. 2 ones are 2, write 2 here. 2 ones are 2, write 2 here. Now put 1 cross here. Now multiply 11,404 by 6. See, 6 fours are 24, write 4 here and 2 carry. 6 zeros are 0, 0 plus 2, 2, write 2 here. 6 fours are 24, write 4 here and 2 carry. 6 ones are 6 plus 2, 8, write 8 here. 6 ones are 6, write 6 here. Now we will do addition. Write 8 here, 0 plus 4, write 4 here, 8 plus 2, 10, write 0 here and 1 carry. 1 plus 2, 3 plus 4, 7, write 7 here. 2 plus 8, 10, write 0 here and 1 carry. 1 plus 6, 7, write 7 here. 11,404 multiply 62 equal to 7,07,048. Write down equal to 7,07,048 plus 22. And after addition, we will get 7,07,070. Left hand side and right hand side both are equal. Hence, answer is verified. Clear? Now, question number 8. 24 mangoes can be packed in one carton. How many cartons will be needed to pack 2,448 mangoes? Answer C. Number of cartons required to pack 24 mangoes equal to 1 carton. Number of cartons required to pack 2,448 mangoes equal to 2,448 divided 24. We will divide 2,448 by 24. Make a sign like this. Write 24 here and write 2,448 here. Okay. Now see. 24 multiply 1 equal to 24. Now we will do subtraction. 4 minus 4, 0. 2 minus 2, 0. And then we will take next number that is 4. But 4 is less than 24. So we will take one more number that is 8. So we will write 0 in quotient. Now the number formed is 48. Now see, 24 multiply 2 equal to 48. And then we will do subtraction. 8 minus 8, 0. 4 minus 4, 0. Clear? Now write down. Therefore, 102 cartons will be required to pack 2,448 mangoes. Therefore, 102 cartons will be required to pack 2,448 mangoes. Clear?
Thank you. Have a nice day.